Hello there, this is Patricia from Pinky's World and this is Stash Buster 2. Well, really you're just using your stamps and your white papers and inks, so you're still busting your stash, I suppose. I had four of these to make every year for the grandkids. I'll soon have five when Amy gets up a wee bit, but at the minute it's just the four boys and I like to decorate everything up. I've got them the penguin cakes. I'm trying to be very sensible with their stuff. Nothing too drastic on their wee teeth. So this is what I'm making the boxes for. I had just threw them into their wee Halloween bags and I thought, ugh, they're awful looking. So I decided to make a wee box. It just opens up the back. Penguin bar fits in perfectly and it's just been stamped and inked using a variety of colours just to spruce it up. I've used Trick or Treat from the Tricks and Treats set. This was from Stampin' Up and I've used that wee ghost. I've also used the postage stamp punch, but just do whatever you want there. You cut a circle or whatever. I've used some black ribbon that I've had for years to add a wee bit of spookiness to each part. So I'm going to show you how to make it. It's very quick and easy. I have used my envelope punch board, so if you have one of those, get it out. That would be what you need. If not, you know, look out for a box that says somewhere else. I'm using the envelope punch board. It's a time saver, in my opinion. So this is made specifically for those penguins. So I think the box measures just under 1¾ by 3¼, and it's an inch deep. So anything that size will fit into it. And I've done red, purple and orange, and this time I'm going to go with a nice greeny colour. But we're going to start cutting our shape on the board. So your paper needs to be 5.5 inches by 5.5 inches. And your first wee cut is going to be 1½, or punch, sorry. So line it up to the 1½ mark. Punch it and score it. And don't turn it round just yet because it is a box we're making. So slide it up to, that flipping light's blinking me. It's supposed to help you, but it's really driving me crazy. Drag it up to 2 7/8. So it's just the notch below the 3 there. Punch and score. And just repeat that the whole way around. Well, no, repeat it. Line it up and repeat it by using the lines as your guide, so you don't have to bother with the measurements. So just make sure that point is on your first line. Do another line, slide it up to the next one, just make sure that wee point is sitting where it should be, and just repeat. On all four sides. Oops, just make sure you get up right into that point. Where am I now? Not concentrating, that's what I'm doing. So line it up there, punch, score, and keep it going. I have missed using this punch board. So that is it all done on all four sides. I want to clip off one of these triangular sides, just round it off, and then on the other one we're going to just take a wee nick off it. So just line your scissors up and just that wee triangle. It doesn't matter what size you take off. And you now want to do a bit of stamping. Stick the sheet under here, you can see where I've done all my inking. So we'll get our wee ghosty, and I have stamped him originally in Memento, but I'm now going into VersaFine because it gives it a much crisper look when you're repeatedly stamping. Put a ink off that, and it gives you a nice clear image. It is messy, just be warned. You get it in your hand, you're liable to get your white. You can use any color of card or paper. I'm using this, it's lightweight card, it's not heavy at all. So my box will sort of be laying this way, so I want the ghosts to be able to see what they're at, especially on this part. And they don't all have to be shaped that way. You can do them upside down or round, or just make them look really random. Don't bother with these four spots here because they're being tucked in, so there's no call for them to be stamped. So just keep repeating that all over your thing and it'll come straight back. Now I'm going to let mine dry there a wee bit because it just takes that wee bit longer to dry than the memento. You want to stamp your other wee bit now and we'll let it dry. And again, I've already originally stamped it up with memento, which helps to clean it a wee bit when you go to clean it, if that's underneath it. And then we're just going in with this VersaMark, isn't it? VersaFine Black. So I've chopped two of these, or punched two of these, one in black, and I've left the postage edge on it. This one I chopped, or punched again, but chopped it down just to the edge, so it's going to fit in there nicely. And then we'll want to stamp this in the center. So we can get these mucky things out of the way. So I'm using a Parakeet Party, so a nice lime green if you have one, and my green brush. And to start with, I'm doing this and I'm hoping it doesn't smudge all over the place. So it may not be fully dry. But I just want to add ink to the top of this around the edges. And even if it does smudge a bit, it makes it more spooky, sure doesn't it? Just adding it to the edges. Just give it a wee bit of definition. And then I'm going to raise it up with wherever they've gone. Oh, for goodness sake. I'm such a messy crafter. Right, I'm adding three of these just so it's well supported for sitting on the black postage stamp. And we're just going to add that now and keep it till later. So just center that in your postage stamp. You can see I've just nicked off the edges just so that it's showing behind there. We'll cut there a bit of ribbon while we're at it. Our ribbon needs to be just longer than that postage stamp thing, and you want to cut it okay that length and then tie a knot, and you have to sort of fold it in half to get to the knot, but you want to slide your knot up to the top and try and get a nice square shape of ribbon and then squeeze it, pull it, so you're leaving that bit of a tail, and just keep working on it. And then you want to do another one at this side. And don't worry if it ends up too short on you, we can chop it in half, which actually makes it easier to do. I want my knots shown at the end of the packaging, so if you do have to cut it in half, do so. So it is going to need cut, but I want to take my scissors now and just slice up the ribbon. Doesn't matter if it frays, it just adds to the spookiness. So you're left with that nice wee feathered bit of ribbon. Do the same at the opposite side. You get about four chops out of it if you're careful. And then because that's so small, I'm going to chop it in half. And I'm going to add just a bit of tape roller to hold it in place, and you just want to stick the flatter end so that the knot is shown above your, so it just shows like that to both sides. You've just a wee neck to catch there, and then we're going to put a piece of, where are ya, under here, a piece of double-sided tape to cover all of that and keep everything neat and tidy. I'm just going to give that a wee press, and then we're just going to leave that for a while and we'll come back to it again. That's that out of the way. So now we want to go to our wee ghosties, and you'll want to do your scores now at this stage. Just score all the lines that you made, and then we're going to do a wee tiny bit of chapping and then inking. Quickest wee box ever, like that. Envelope punch maker. If you haven't got one, get yourself one. I think they're really worth their money for envelopes and boxes. So we have these four that we need to chop into. So I'm just going to go to the skinnier end, one with this wee point. And by the way, you can round those off too if you want. Chop up that score line and chop a wee bit of it off on both sides. Right. So now we're ready to do some inking. And say, just grab your ink. I'm going to start at one of the fatter ends and just build it up. And I'm just doing the edges. I'm still leaving white. I want to show the white. But when you come to your first crease, bend it down, twist it over, and make sure that you do both sides of the crease. Otherwise, it'll show when you fold your box. So weave it there, turn it back over, and do it there. And the same with your wee corners, because they will show. So fold them back, turn them over, oops. And then just keep going, doing that, working yourself the whole way down, and it'll come straight back to you. So when you have your other side done, just flip it over and use it. Use your brush cleaning technique here, just to get rid of any excess. You don't have to do the inside, but I think it does look a bit better when you do it. So clean, use that as cleaning your brush there to get rid of excess ink. And now we're ready to sort of put it together. These will be glued on and held up. So this is where you want to mark your wee fold. So the best way to do it is to actually fold that up. Get yourself a ruler. And use that guideline and just go to the other side of it and just a couple of wee creases, and that gives you that mark which you will use to fold down. And you really need to add another wee bit of ink to that, of course, which I totally forgot. So just hold it and add a wee bit of ink to the end of it. That's enough. So now we need a wee tuck for our this to fold into. So again, fold it up, use a pencil and put a dot to either side of it. And you'll know that you need to cut from there to there along that seam. Alright, so I'm just using a Stanley blade here, just roughly, from dot to dot. And then go in with your, and just to give it a wee round to make it that wee bit easier to get your paper in, just gives it a better wee split. And again, you can run your brush over that to make it a wee bit darker, and when you lift it up or put it all together, you might want to do that. So fold these in, and we're going to put glue on. This also gives the box a wee bit of stability if your card is like mine, a bit lightweight. Or you don't have to do any of that inking if you fancy just using a coloured card and stamping your wee ghosts onto it. So that would save you a bit of time if you had a lot to do, if you're doing them for a craft fair or something. So just join all those up. Just make sure they're nice and lined up. So So that should be fine. And we're going to fit our wee bun inside. Fold the inner ones in, fold this one down, and then this one just clips in here. And that keeps it closed for you. And as I said, if you thought it needed a wee bit more ink, now's the time to do it before you close up everything. That all looks okay. So what we'll need to do is add this. So we're just going to take off our sticky back paper and get a grip of it. And just for extra security, I'm adding some more of the Tomboy glue because it does give it a nice wee hold. And we're just sticking this on flat. And that will just sit in the centre between top and bottom, roughly. Give it a wee hold, and that should be your boxes. Thankfully I've only folded, as I said, so it's nice to do them in nice wee different colours, and such an easy box. Get your envelope punch board out and have a bit of fun with it. And that's it. I'll catch us all again next week. Thanks very much for watching. Bye.